Hi guys, this is Joshi, and again I'm here with you on the platform of Achieve IAS. So today we are going to discuss about International Criminal Code, that is ICC, that is recently in news, and we are going to discuss it because it is important according to our prelims point of view. Whether you are going some kind of SSCs, UPSCs, you have to go through this topic. And this is the most important topic for our current scenario. Okay, so let's go through it and have a look why it is in news and what is it, and why it is important, and what is International Criminal Court at all. Let's go through it. First of all, I would like to let you know that International Criminal Court is a court where all the matters related to international criminal topics are discussed in this court, and criminal topics that are related to even countries, then those topics should be discussed here only. Okay. So in this topic, we are going to read all about International Criminal Court. Its headquarter is in Hague. Okay, so let's have a look towards it. Why it is in news? Philippines moves to quit International Criminal Court. There have been withdrawals in the recent past, namely. Okay, then why Philippines moves to quit it, and what is the reason behind this? So let's have a look towards it. But before that, let's know about ICC. The International Criminal Court is an intergovernmental organization and international tribunal that sits in The Hague in the Netherlands. Okay, so I already discussed about you that headquarter is in Hague, and that is in Netherlands. Okay, so it is an intergovernmental organization and international tribunal. Okay, so the ICC has the jurisdiction to prosecute individuals for the international crimes of genocide, crimes against humanity, and war crimes. The ICC is intended to complement existing national judicial systems, and it may therefore only exercise its jurisdiction when certain conditions are met, such as when national courts are unwilling or unable to prosecute criminals, or when the United Nations Security Council or individual states refer situation to the court. Okay, so I would like to let you know that here recently what is going on, that is coronavirus. So coronavirus, related to coronavirus, there is a claim against China from USA, okay, and other related companies, where it affected a lot. Okay, so here China has been claimed for expanding such type of, or exploring such type of virus or such type of disease that is totally destroying the world. And this claim is discussed in International Criminal Court. It will be discussed there after completing all these matters at all. Okay, so the ICC has this jurisdiction to prosecute individuals for the international crimes of genocide and crimes against humanity and war crimes. Okay, the ICC is intended to complement existing national judicial system, and it may therefore only exercise its jurisdiction when certain conditions are met, such as when national courts are unwilling or unable to prosecute criminals. Okay, so here I repeated these lines again because these are important. That what is the, these are the lines where it has been discussed that what are the basic work of ICC. Okay, so such as when national courts are unwilling or unable to prosecute criminals, then when the United Nations Security Council or individual states refer situation to the court, then it will be discussed in ICC. Okay, so ICC began functioning on 1st July 2002, the date that the Rome Statute entered into force. The Rome Statute is a multilateral treaty which serves as the ICC's foundational and governing document. states which become party to the Rome Statute. For example, by ratifying it, become member states of the ICC. Currently, there are 123 states which are party to the Rome Statute and therefore members of the ICC. Okay, so India and also US and China has neither signed nor ratified the Rome Statute on the International Criminal Court. It is important that India has not ratified or signed the Rome Statute. Okay, so recent withdrawals including Burundi and Russia, etc. What are the reasons for Philippines stains? Okay, what is the basic reason that why Philippines going to quit the ICC and what are the reason behind this? The ICC announced on Feb a preliminary examination into allegation Philippine police have killed thousands of alleged users or dealers as part of Duterte's anti-drug war that he launched after taking office in mid-2016. Okay, however, the withdrawal from the ICC only takes effect after a year from notification and therefore ICC can still investigate the cases. Okay, so what are the problems with the ICC? Bureaucratic structure, okay, procedural and substantive deficiencies have marred the work of the court, leading to the lengthy delays and frustrations. Its effectiveness has been questioned because of the pace with which it completes the cases. Okay, scarcity of human and financial resources, question of the legitimacy, and only two of the permanent members of the UN Security Council are members of the court. Yet the Security Council can refer situations to the prosecutor with no effective follow-up. Okay. So these are the problems with ICC. And what is the relation or what is the performance of India with ICC, India and ICC? Okay, so India has not been its part for reason related the absence of provisions there whereby the state could accept the jurisdiction of ICC by declaration of a limited conduct and for a specified time. Absence of such provision amounts to threat the sovereignty. So India is yet not being the part of ICC. Okay, India has anxieties regarding how investigation, prosecution and criminal proceedings will be judged by the international court. It means clearly I can say that India is not satisfied with the work of ICC. How ICC is working and what is the procedure of it, what are the jurisdiction of it and what is the investigation system, prosecution of it. India is yet not satisfied and still got anxieties regarding, it has anxieties regarding the investigation and prosecutions. Okay, so the inclusion of armed conflict in the list of war crimes in a cause of concern for India with respect to conflicts in Kashmir, Northeast and other regions of India. So ICC didn't give any type of good governance regarding or good statements regarding Kashmir or Northeast or other regions of India regarding the issues. Okay, so still we are also in conflict to join it or not. Court might be biased and might run with political motives of international orders. Okay, so it was all about the India with ICC and what are the relation of India with ICC and why yet India has not been the part of ICC. Okay, so what are the way forward? It states should actively encourage cooperation and sanctions non-cooperations. Okay, and states parties should support human rights defenders working towards international justice and the fulfillment of the ICC's mandate and implement all necessary measures to protect them. It increased universality. The court leads to broaden its ambit and include more permanent members of UN into its fold to establish credibility. States have an obligation to cooperate with the ICC as it does not have its own police force. The court suffers cruelly from the insufficient cooperation of the states, which weakens its authority and efficiency. Hence, the financial and manpower issues need to be addressed. Strengthening of investigation and prosecutions, support for participation and effective presentation of victim. So, as on conclusion, I can say that ICC is a good platform to join, and it can be a good platform if ICC will work on these type of topics. That if it will be increasing its working strategies and its way of working will be improved, or I can say the cooperation of states should be done, and if it will be going to broaden its working areas or permanent members, then it will be establishment of credibility, and I can say it will be a good platform to go through accountability. If accountability will be done, then definitely it will be a good it will be a platform where all these states are going to come and join it, and they will definitely got justice from here. So for that, it is a good platform, but still there are so many laps in this court, and it should be done accordingly, because for that we should go through some strategic points, and we have to go through ICC have to work on prosecutions, investigations, strategies, and it has to broaden its surface, its area, working area, and state should also cooperate it and section the non-cooperation, and all these things will be done. If all these things will be done, then definitely it will be a good platform to join, and the clearance of so many issues that are going in between states, and there will be a definitely a chance to decrease the number of cases that are happening, criminal cases or other cases that are happening interstates, or it is going through international platform. Okay, so I think we should, other states or permanent members or the authorized parties should work on it, and definitely it will be a good platform to go with. Bye bye. Thanks for watching, and thanks for being with me. I will be here with you with a brand new session next time. So I'll be here with you. Keep watching. Bye bye. Take care.